Hey guys, a very good day to you all. So in this video we will see what is MOT, that is Molecular Orbital Theory. So what Molecular Orbital Theory states that when atomic orbitals combine with each other, they form new molecular orbitals. So let's understand what is meant by this. So we all know that electrons revolve in the atom in particular orbitals, that is S, P, D and F, and we call these orbitals as atomic orbitals. And for forming a molecule, we must have a bond, and that bond consists of two electrons, one electron from one atom and another electron from the another atom. So when these electrons, which are moving in S, P, D and F, when they combine with each other, that is the atomic orbitals S and S combine with each other, or S or P combine with each other, they form new molecular orbitals, which are known as, which are signified by sigma, pi, delta and so on. So these are nothing but molecular orbitals. So let's keep it simple. Electrons revolve in the atom in the orbitals S, P, D and F, and we call them as atomic orbitals. Say in the same way, the electrons which are forming bond, they revolve in the molecule in the orbitals, molecular orbitals known as sigma, pi, delta and so on. So this is what molecular orbital actually wanted to state. So this is what molecular orbital theory meant. Now we will see further on that there are two types of molecular orbitals. One is bonding molecular orbitals, and another one is the opposite of it, that is antibonding molecular orbitals. So we will see what is bonding molecular orbitals and antibonding molecular orbitals. We all know that for forming a bond, two electrons must have same energy. So if the two electrons of the respective atoms are moving in same direction, we get bonding molecular orbitals, and if the two electrons of the two atoms are moving in opposite direction, we get what is known as antibonding molecular orbitals. So now, as the electrons move in the form of a wave, if a constructive interference takes place, as the electrons are moving in same direction, that is a crest of one and a crest of another overlap with each other, we get constructive interference. So as the electrons moving in same direction, we get constructive interference, and this constructive interference leads to bonding molecular orbitals. In short, bonding molecular orbitals are known for constructive interference. So two electrons of respective atoms combine with each other as they travel in the form of wave. So we all must know that the electron around a nucleus travels in the form of a wave. So when the two atoms of respective when the two electrons of respective atoms combine with each other, if the crest of one and the crest of another overlap with each other, they give rise to constructive interference, and thus bonding molecular orbitals are formed. And in the case of antibonding molecular orbitals, destructive interference takes place. So the here what we can say is that the electrons of the respective atoms which are combining to form a molecule, they are moving in the opposite direction, and this leads to antibonding molecular orbitals. And further on, as the destructive interference takes place, more energy is released. And thus antibonding molecular orbitals have more energy and bonding molecular orbitals have lesser energy. And we all know that greater the energy, less will be the stability, as it is inversely proportional to each other. So antibonding molecular orbitals are unstable and bonding molecular orbitals are more stable as compared to the antibonding molecular orbitals. So what we have seen from start is that MOT states that when atomic orbitals, that is s, p, d and f, when they combine with each other during the formation of a bond, they give rise to new molecular orbitals known as sigma, pi and delta. And now these sigma, pi and delta are again of two types, that is bonding molecular orbitals and antibonding molecular orbitals. Let me tell you one more point, that these bonding molecular orbitals are signified by sigma, pi, delta as it is, and antibonding molecular orbitals are signified by sigma star, pi star and delta star. Just to distinguish between both of them, we have given a star to antibonding molecular orbitals. And bonding molecular orbitals are formed when constructive interference takes place between the atom electrons of respective atoms which combine to form a bond. So if the electrons are moving in same direction which are forming a bond, we get constructive interference and thus bonding molecular orbitals are formed. And if the electrons of respective atoms are moving in opposite direction which are forming the bond, we get antibonding molecular orbital. So as the here destructive interference takes place, we get more energy, and this will, as there is more energy, this will be unstable, and as there is less energy, this will be more stable. So now let's understand how to draw a molecular orbital theory diagram with an example. So let's consider that two oxygen molecules are forming a molecule known as O2. So in the formation of O2, first of all we must know what is the electron configuration for oxygen. So electron configuration oxygen is nothing but 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. So over here two oxygens are combining with each other to form a molecule. So first of all, what we must do is that let's consider this one oxygen molecule over here and another oxygen molecule over here. Over here at the bottom, we must start with the bottom and go till the up, that is the above end. So over here you must draw this one S2 of this oxygen molecule. So I have written over here as 1s2, and for this oxygen molecule again I have, below it I will write 1s2. So over here in 1s there is two electrons, so two electrons with opposite spins, and over here two electrons with another opposite spins. And when these electrons form molecular orbital, so 1s2 is atomic orbital, right, and this 1s2 is also atomic orbital, so now they will form a molecular orbital. Okay, so this is the molecular orbital. So when S and S combine with each other, we get single bond, and therefore we write as sigma. Sigma S2, and over here also we write as sigma S2. So these are two types of molecular orbitals which have formed, and we know that antibonding molecular orbitals have greater energy, so we have written them antibonding molecules on the top. So they have, since they have greater energy, we have written on top, and antibonding molecular are signified by this star. So over here we can write it as sigma 1s2, okay, and sigma star 1s2. Now let's draw for this 2s2. Over for this 2s2, there are two electrons with opposite spins, and for this oxygen also there are two electrons with opposite spins. So this is 2s2 and this is another 2s2. Now when this atomic orbitals combine with each other, they will form another molecular orbitals. So this will not be nothing but our sigma 2s2, sigma 2s2, and as antibody molecules are written on the top, we write it as sigma star 2s2 and sigma 2s2. And further on, let's draw for 2p4. So for 2p4, as p can be represented by 3 columns, so let's fill these 4 electrons according to Hund's rule. So these are the 4 electrons, that is 2p4 of this oxygen atom, and this is another 2p4 of this oxygen atom. So now how these 2p orbitals are formed, let's see. We are not writing all 3 columns in one, we are distinguishing them in 2. So they, or these 3 columns are distinguished in 2 and 1. So now how to represent them is that this will be, since pi 2p are for combining with each other, we have to write as pi px and pi py, pi 2px and pi 2py, and over here also we will write pi 2px and pi 2py, and over here we are just considering this as pi 2pz. And as these are antibonding, we must write as pi star, and this will be also pi star. So now how to fill these columns, let's see. First of all, these 2 electrons, so write these 2 electrons over here, then write these 2 electrons over here. So this is done, this part is done. Now let's move above. Write these 2 electrons over here, and write another these 2 electrons over here. Now over here there are 4, so let's first of all fill the 4 states. 2 are done, and another 4 are done. So these 4 electrons are filled over here. Now let's fill these 4 electrons, these 4 electrons over here, 1, 2, and over here 2 are left, so we have to write in this manner. So this is a diagram for molecular orbital of 2 oxygen molecules or 2 oxygen atoms forming a molecule known as O2. Now over here they will tell us to find the bond order. So bond order is nothing but the sum of bonding electrons minus the antibonding electrons. So let's calculate the bonding. I'll first write the formula over here. Bond order is nothing but equals to half into bonding minus antibonding. So let's see how many electrons are bonding over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Don't count the star ones. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, and 10. So half into 10 minus antibonding. Antibonding are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So over here we are counting the starred ones. So in this way 4. So the bond order of the O2 molecule is 2. So guys, thanks for watching the video. Please do subscribe to the channel and share the video as much as possible. And in the playlist you will be finding all the videos of science related everything, 11, 12, and as well as engineering.